What do a melting ice cube, a wildfire spreading, and a stock market crash all have in common? They all seem random, chaotic, unpredictable. But beneath this chaos, hidden mathematical rules govern everything. And one mathematician, Hugo Duminil-Copin, has spent his career uncovering them. His breakthroughs in probability and statistical physics help explain phase transitions, those moments when a system suddenly changes state. Think water freezing, magnets flipping their poles, or even how diseases spread. This episode is the first in a four-part series exploring the extraordinary work of the 2022 Fields Medal winners, mathematicians who have revolutionized their respective fields. And today we begin with Hugo Duminil-Copin, a man who uncovered the hidden mathematics of randomness and phase transitions. The Fields Medal is often referred to as the Nobel Prize of Mathematics, though it has its own unique prestige. Established in 1936, the medal is awarded every 4 years to outstanding mathematicians under the age of 40, recognizing exceptional contributions to the field. The award is given by the International Mathematical Union and is presented at the International Congress of Mathematicians. Some of the greatest minds in mathematics have received the Fields Medal, including Terence Tao, Mariam Mazzocchini, and Grigori Perelman, figures whose work has profoundly shaped modern mathematical thought. The medal not only honours groundbreaking research, but also serves as an inspiration for the next generation of mathematicians. Winning the Fields Medal is no small feat. It signifies that the recipient has solved or significantly advanced some of the most complex mathematical problems of our time. And in 2022, one of those brilliant minds was Hugo Duminil-Copin, whose revolutionary work on probability theory and phase transitions is the focus of this first episode. So, how did a handball-playing teenager from France end up winning the Fields Medal? And why does his work matter to, well, everything? Hugo Duminil-Copin was born in 1985 in Châtenay-Malabry, a suburb of Paris. But unlike many of his fellow Fields Medalists, he wasn't a child prodigy. Actually, he wanted to be a professional handball player. His father, a sports teacher, and his mother, a former dancer turned teacher, encouraged him to explore many things: sports, music, science. It was all part of his upbringing. It wasn't until high school that mathematics caught his full attention. Even then, he wasn't at the top of his class. When he attempted to qualify for the International Mathematical Olympiad, he failed. But what he lacked in raw speed, he made up for in perseverance and creativity. His fascination with patterns and structures led him to the prestigious École Normale Supérieure, where he initially pursued physics. But something about physics felt incomplete. Mathematics, with its rigid logic and undeniable proofs, had something physics lacked: certainty. And that was the beginning of a journey that would shake the foundations of probability theory. Duminil-Copin's field of expertise is statistical physics, a branch of physics and mathematics that studies systems with a large number of interacting components, using probability and statistical methods to predict behaviour. It seeks to bridge microscopic rules governing individual particles with the large-scale behaviours we observe, such as phase transitions in matter. His work particularly focuses on percolation theory, the Ising model, and the Potts model, which describe how materials undergo sudden shifts in their physical state when certain thresholds are reached. Imagine you are pouring coffee into a filter. If there are enough open gaps in the coffee grounds, water flows through. If not, it gets trapped. Simple, right? This is percolation theory, and it turns out it applies to much more than coffee. It models forest fires, epidemics, and even material strength. But despite its importance, the field was stuck. Mathematicians understood simple percolation models, but real-world systems are rarely simple. They involve dependencies, where the state of one part affects the others. For example, in disease spread modelling, a simple percolation model assumes infections occur randomly between individuals. However, in reality, social networks create dependencies. If one person becomes infected, the likelihood of their close contacts also becoming infected increases, making spread non-random and much harder to predict with basic percolation theory. This is where Duminil-Copin made his mark. He generalised percolation theory to handle complex interdependent systems. His work revealed exactly when a system will undergo a sudden transition, a tipping point where order dissolves into chaos, or vice versa. And one of the most important places this happens is magnets. Just as percolation helps us understand when a system transitions from blocked to connected, similar ideas apply to magnetism. Imagine a material where tiny atomic spins interact, like water flowing through a filter. At high temperatures, these spins fluctuate randomly, much like a disordered percolation system. But as the temperature lowers, a sudden transformation occurs. It's just like reaching the percolation threshold. The Ising model describes how these tiny atomic spins align to create magnetism. At high temperatures, spins are disorganized, cool things down past a certain threshold, and suddenly order emerges. In two dimensions, Lars Onsager famously solved the Ising model in 1944, providing an exact mathematical expression for how spins align as temperature changes. However, in three and four dimensions, solving the model meant proving whether the phase transition is continuous or discontinuous. Duminil-Copin cracked it. He proved that the transition is continuous in three dimensions and trivial in four, resolving conjectures that had stood since the mid-20th century. His unique insight came from developing novel techniques that bridged probability theory and statistical physics, allowing him to rigorously establish phase transition properties in dimensions that had long eluded mathematicians. By leveraging innovative renormalization methods and deep connections between percolation and the Ising model, he provided precise mathematical proofs where previous attempts had relied on heuristic arguments. You might be asking yourself, okay, so Duminil-Copin figured out when systems like water, magnets, or gases suddenly change state? Cool. But why does this matter beyond pure math? As it turns out, it matters a lot. Duminil-Copin's proof reshaped multiple scientific fields. In epidemiology, his models help predict how diseases like COVID-19 spread, allowing for better intervention strategies. In artificial intelligence and neural networks, his mathematical insights enhance models dealing with uncertainty, improving decision-making and optimization algorithms. His work has also impacted finance, where his theories help refine risk assessment models, making market crash predictions more precise. In materials science, his findings enable the development of stronger, more resilient materials used in aerospace construction and nanotechnology. His contributions to quantum physics aid in understanding quantum phase transitions, paving the way for advancements in quantum computing. His research touches nearly every field where uncertainty reigns. And that's most of them. Despite all these breakthroughs, Hugo Duminil-Copin remains, well, refreshingly normal. His colleagues describe him as highly collaborative, rarely working alone. An interview with Quantum magazine mentioned that he's known for shouting excitedly during discussions, getting so animated that nearby officers have to ask him to close his door. He thinks in drawings more than equations, visualizing problems before tackling them. And like his childhood love for sports, he approaches maths like a team game where ideas bounce between people until something clicks. Outside of his mathematical pursuits, Duminil-Copin leads a balanced life. He lives in Switzerland, where he teaches at the University of Geneva and holds a permanent position at the prestigious Institut des Hautes Scientifiques in France. Despite his towering academic achievements, he remains deeply connected to his personal life. He is married and has a daughter, prioritizing family time amidst his intense research schedule. His love for sports continues, often serving as both a physical and mental refreshment. Mathematics has long been seen as the art of order and precision, but Duminil-Copin's work reveals something deeper, that even in chaos, there is structure. The next time you see ice melt, or hear about a market crash, or watch a viral trend explode online, remember, somewhere in the randomness, hidden mathematical laws are at play. And thanks to mathematicians like Hugo Duminil-Copin, we're starting to decode them.